Hey guys, in this video I will continue my exploration of 2D lighting effects on tilemaps in Godot 3.1. I applied this effect for a little pixel art scene as you see in a dark cave. Here a little kitty is confronted with lots of ugly enemies. Using the lighting, the attention is focused on the main character. The effect is very easy to implement, and within an instance you can even throw shadows on your tilemap. Sounds good? Let's get started! To show you how to implement this lighting effect for tilemaps, I have created a new project in Godot. I start by creating a new 2D scene, and inside my project I placed a simple background texture. I drag it into the scene, duplicate it, and place the second texture beside the first. I finish this step by saving the scene. We continue by adding a tile map to our 2D scene. A tile map needs a tile set, so we click on the respective entry in the inspector and open our brand new tile editor. We then expand by clicking the arrows in the lower right corner, and we can add a texture by clicking on the plus sign in the lower left corner. For creating a new tile, it's best to enhance the view and zoom in a little bit. And now we can go on and click on the new single tile. Please make sure that the snap grid settings is activated, and I click on the texture to generate my new tile. Now I can save, and I store my tileset.trs in the tileset folder. I quickly generate a collision map for my tile. I make sure that the snap grid settings are activated, so I choose the create new polygon tool and click in each of the four corners of the tile to generate points for the polygon collider. I finish this step by clicking on the first point again at the end. You can check that you have succeeded creating a new polygon collider if a light blue square appears on your tile. And as I want to cast shadows on this tile, I also need an occlusion map. Again, I make sure that the snap grid settings are activated, and I choose the create new polygon tool. Don't forget to save at the end. And after returning to the scene, we can paint straightforward on our tile map. One last thing I forgot is to adapt the cell size of my tile map to the tile I just created. It has to be 32 times 32 in X and Y direction for this specific tile set. Now I quickly generate some small structures for my player to jump on. One bug I experienced in the beta version of Godot was at this point that after generating the tilemap and exiting the editor, even if I had saved the scene before, the whole tilemap was messed up when I opened the editor again. So just to remind you, the Godot beta is more for playing around with new features than for creating real-life projects. I assume that you know how to create a basic character controller. For mine, I used a simplified version of the little character you have seen in the intro. I merged it to my main node from a scene which I prepared and saved previously. Basically, my 2D character consists of a kinematic body 2D with a collider shape and some ray casts to detect if the character is on the ground or jumping. I have also added a 2D camera to follow the player. To make the character stand out from the dark background, I will now go on and add a 2D light to it. The only thing I have to do is to drag my light 2D under my player and to load a texture into the texture slot. I'm using a 512 pixel measuring image I created in Krita. On a black background, I simply draw a white gradient using my foreground color. You can easily create such an image using an image software of your choice. After exporting my image to my Godot project folder, I can now go on and select the PNG file as a texture for my 2D light. I also scale it down a little to a factor of 0.2 in X and Y direction. And to make our tile map affected by the texture light, we also have to enable the shadows checkbox in our light 2D. If we now go on and hit play, you will realize that our player is surrounded by a nice glowing halo, and also that our tile map casts smooth shadows. And that's what I love about Godot. Small and simple effects, easy to configure, which give your game this special appeal. I would be so happy about your subscription or a quick thumb up. And perhaps you even think about joining and supporting the quick growing Godot game developer community on Patreon. Hope to hear from you and that we meet again. Bye!